Hey y'all, Sherelle Martin here with Nitron Financial Solutions, where we help business owners manage the financial health of their business so they can find the money leaks, increase their cash flow, and maximize their profits. We're also the founders of the Rock the Books online bookkeeper training program, where you can become a certified bookkeeper and start your bookkeeping business in less than 90 days. So today we're going to talk about the five things you must know before setting up a brand new business entity. So within our program, we teach you how to become a rockstar bookkeeper, but we also give you the tools and the resources to help start your brand new bookkeeping business. And one of those things is how to set up a business properly. And so in the midst of COVID, a lot of people started their brand new businesses, stepped out, you know, on faith and jumped into the entrepreneurial pool and wanted to start their new business. And so what we've me and some colleagues have seen is that they're not setting up the right business entity for them. They're basing it off what they see on other social media platforms or what their friends, sisters, brothers, cousins may have told them, but they're not doing the due diligence of making sure that what they're establishing is in fact something that they need to establish and best for them. And so I wanted to share these five things with you so that you can know before setting up and choosing the type of entity you want to be, that you want to be sure that you've chosen the right one. And so here are the five things you need to know. So the first thing you need to know and be aware of is how many owners are required for the business. So whether you're going this alone, you want to be a solopreneur, or you're starting to set up a business with one or more partners, you want to know the minimum and the maximum number of shareholders and or members or partners that is required for that entity. Each entity has a minimum and or maximum number that is required, and you need to know that going in so that you can choose the right entity for you. The second, because you want to make sure, that the one that you choose is also the best from a tax perspective. You want the one that's the right setup, but as far as structure, but also that provides you with the best tax benefit for you. The second thing you need to be aware of is how each entity is taxed. So each entity is taxed differently. Most of them are taxed at the individual level. So they're, the income from the business passes through to the individual owners and it gets taxed on your personal tax return. But there is, in the instance of a corporation, where it's taxed at the entity level. And so you end up paying tax on your personal distributions or dividends that are taken, but you also get taxed at the business entity level. And so that's something a lot of people are not aware of. And so you need to be aware of how each different entity is taxed. The third thing you need to be aware of is any personal liability requirements. So personal liability means that in the event that the business owner incurs any type of business debt in the course of operating, or if there's any claims against the business legally, you as the owner may be liable for some of that. And so you need to be aware of which entities where the owners are liable and which ones they are not. Obviously, we want the ones that are not, but you still need to know. The fourth thing you need to know is the ease of setup. So every entity is set up differently, and the requirements to set up one is not the same as the other, and some are easier to set up than others. And so if you're looking to do this alone, you want to be a solopreneur or sole proprietor, that process is a lot simpler and easier than if you wanted to be a corporation. You also need to know this from the perspective of, if you do decide that the corporation is the best route, you may need to engage a lawyer to help you set up all of the documents required for that corporation. And so I definitely recommend speaking to your accountant or lawyer before you set up your business entity, but be aware that if you choose the corporation route, you may need to engage a lawyer further in order to set it up properly. And the fifth thing that you need to know before you're setting up a business entity is that you need to be aware of the ongoing state requirements. So every state has different ongoing requirements for setting up a business and maintaining that business within that state. Every single state is different. drives me crazy, but it is what it is. And so you need to be aware that some states require annual return filings. Some of those filings incorporate an annual filing fee, and that fee can be as low as $50, or it can be well into the hundreds of dollars. I think one particular state might even be $700. And so you want to make sure that you know what the requirements are for the state that you're in, so that you can be aware and know that you need to do that and put that into your mind as something that needs to be handled annually. A lot of businesses don't file that requirement because they simply say they didn't know. I know in Maryland, we have an annual filing that costs $300 every year in order to maintain the business and keep the business's name. And a lot of businesses in Maryland say they didn't know that they had to do it every year. But they end up finding out through some sort of search or trying to bid on some contract or something that their business is defaulted and that they're not active because they hadn't been maintaining that over the course of however many years. So you need to make sure that you're aware of what is required for your state, because every state is different. So to recap, the five things that you need to know before you set up a new business entity is that you need to know the number of owners that are required, minimum and maximum. You need to be aware of how the entity is taxed so that you're not surprised come next year. You need to be aware of any personal liability requirements if that business incurs any debt. You need to know the ease of setup and how simple or easy it is, because you may need additional funds to hire a lawyer to help you set up the business to make sure it's set up properly. And you need to be aware of the ongoing state requirements so that you can stay compliant and do your proper filings and keep your business properly maintained and not forfeit your name. So those are the five things you need to know before you set up a business entity. I hope this video has helped you. If so, please hit the like button and also subscribe. Talk to you guys next time.